name is Maria, and today I'm going to be working in this social science project with you guys. For this tutorial, the first thing that we need to do is to download, sorry, this file. It's free for TurboSquid. You can download it here. For more polygons, we need like level 2. So I already downloaded it. And the other thing that I already did, it was coming to Mesh Lab, and I bring the model. I'm for a mesh. I have it in my downloads. This is the mesh from TurboSquid, and what I did was to filters, samplings, and Monte Carlo sampling to create more like points to instance, and after that you turn off this view and you can exporter. I'm going to copy, like, give you the link of this Monte Carlo mesh if you don't want to do it and if you don't want to download this software. But you need to export the match, and for example, I'm going to call it human. It's already in the format POI. We're gonna save it, and here, just so you know, you need to unclick this one, and we'll be ready to go. It will export, and you are going to use that as the base for the Toshi Center tutorial. But as I say, I'll link the TurboSquid profile if you want to download and do it, but I also going to link the model per se. Already modified in MeshLab. So as always, I'm going to delete everything. I'm going to leave the Monte Carlo, the humanoid Monte Carlo, because I already have it. And we are going to start from here. So the first thing that we need to do is, as always, I'm going to have a null from my model, and I'm going to turn off the view. But here I already have them. If you want to activate and view as image, this is the point cloud, how it looks. But I usually want to double check that everything is correct. So I like to see it as an image. But you can see it whatever you prefer. So from this null, we're going to rename it to null position because this is one is going to be the one that we're going to instance. And for this one, I'm going to use a sphere. So I'm going to add a sphere and a null as always. From here, I'm going to bring my geometry from the CAM. Going to have camera. I'm also going to bring a render. I'm going to have, and this is going to be the node I'm going to. I'm going to change the resolution. I'm going to invert these levels to this resolution. I'm going to move this a little bit far. And between these, I already know that I don't want a sphere as a mesh. So I need a polygon. And I want a really simple sphere. I'm also going to have a transform. And this transform is going to be like 0.2 for now. In here, what we're gonna do when we start seeing something is come to the geometry and the instance toggle on. We're going to use the translate. It's no plus station, and we're going to have for R, G, B, and in the camera, I'm going to activate, and I'm going to mode. So we have our humanoid already instant, and we're gonna save. A good measure, so I'm going to already start turn off the viewer. And we are going to start with the setup. This is pretty simple. So as you can see, we're going to first manipulate the point cloud. So from this one, I'm going to add a threshold in the top square, so both of the inputs of the noise need to be one for the threshold and the other part. Point cloud. So after that, we need a material. So I'm going to use a, and I'm going to add a mold. And I got into on the material. We don't have a light, and for that reason, it's all black. So we need a light in hand. And so, to be honest, what I like to get, I don't like the light is really important. So I'm going to come down. And I'll modify this a little bit later, but for now, let's change the color. If we follow what I did before, I have like an orange of this color. It looks pretty nice. And we are going to have over, and this over is going to have a constant. Okay, let's change the input to 1, and we are going to use the same orange, but we're going to go to like a really dark yellow, almost black. This is pretty much what is going on. I really like the feedback loops, so I add one here. Let's add it. This is a static, so you can add it or no. We're going to have a blue, and after the blue, we are going to have a left. Going to say, and from here, composite. I'm going to wear this one. I'm going to add the composite. We're going to have add, and we're going to feedback the target. It's going to be composite, and on the level in posh tab. Are going to be. We're going to have a little bit of opacity. So the other thing that is missing is that previous two cameras. You know, I really, really like to have two cameras. So I'm going to add another one, and I'm going to have an Summer Blend. So I'm going to add this here together. And what we are going to do, Camera Blend, we are going to change the camera from Cam 1 to Camera Blend. And instead of blend, the type is going to be sequence. So at the moment, they're all the same. I'm going to turn off these and quickly before I show you. So for camera one, for example, we have this view, and in camera two, we are going to activate with the A. We're going to go a little bit closer. So in here, we're going to come from camera one to camera two. And we are going to animate this with an elephant from the show family. So I know that I need an elephant with teeth. I'm going to add a map. And we're going to have a null. So if you depress shift when you're in the top menu, everything that you add is going to come to the network array link, so you don't need to add one by one the operators. So in this case, I'm going to change the frequency to something like 0.1 or 0.2. And I need everything positive because I know I'm going to come from minus 1 to 1. It's going to now range to 0 to 1. And this null is going to be, I'm going to active this null and I'm going to have reference over here. A little bit too fast in comparison to what I have. So maybe let's do 0.5. And the LFO. So I'm going to turn off the view and the same with this. And we are in the light. I'm going to active and be deciding. Active a little bit. In the properties, we are going to turn on shadows to hard shadows. Change a lot. Every background lighting is really important. And we're going to change the type of light to cone instead of coin. And I already have like a setup that I like from my previous network, but you can play with this and have like different looks. So, because we have also the dark shadows, it's also important where are you and then. I like this, and so I'm going to save as it is. I really like the dramatic look, and maybe we can play material. Maybe we can go a little bit dark. And if you want to, I didn't do it previously, but you can come to the light and you can color the light and that's going to change the color of your project. I don't really want to change it. I like the color I choose. And this is all. It's a really simple but I recommend. It looks really nice from aesthetic reason. I'm going to have a noise. I really like the look. A little bit of noise, so I change the period to 0, and in the output I come to the noise scale, and you can add a little bit more. I like less, but it changed. You can see a little bit of change on the look. I really like it, gives it more like that. And after that you can come and in this nice star going crazy in the period. If you go like more, it's going to be a softer move. If you come less, going to get like really really funky. I like a bit more of this type of move, but you can play with it. Also in the amplitude and kind of and go be crazy. But for this exercise I want something to still see the humanoid or like the human shape. I'm getting too crazy again. Do you go as crazy as you want? And this is all. I hope you enjoy it, and if you do it, let me know. And if you have questions, also let me know. I would love to see if somebody do the tutorial. This is all. Thank you so much.